plowing these fields all along. And my body odor got things strong. I got dirt in my ear and my throat is cracked and dry. So I'm gonna go home and got it clean. Take all the money I got, it saved from selling the cream. There will be no more compromising with the dust on the horizon. I'm gonna go where there's wine and good-looking women for me. Like a whinstone plowboy, riding out in my pickup with a bottle of good bingo. Like a whinstone plowboy, getting kisses and hugs from women I don't even know. Oh boy, what a way to go. Well, I went to a massage parlor to send a message home to my brother. And boy, was I surprised when she told me to get up on the table. I sometimes dreamed of the things she was due, and I don't even care when she stick the money I got hid in my shoe. There's no more dust on my horizon, and I feel it, my temperature rising. Think of the things that the woman was doing to me. Like a whinstone plowboy, riding out in my pickup with a bottle of good bingo. Like a whinstone plowboy, I got in kisses and hugs from women I don't even know. Oh boy, what a way to go. Big city had class. Instead of cutting, they're smoking the grass. And I spend my time waiting for red lights that never turn green. My body is aching and paining, but the city's just too much for this old Ukrainian. No more fun and game, you see, 'cause my body is rejecting me. So it's back to the homestead where I know they won't find me. Like a whinstone plowboy, riding out in my pickup with a bottle of good bingo. Like a whinstone plowboy, I'm getting kisses and hugs from women I don't even know.
I once knew a couple nurses, Ukrainian nurse. Everything she do was do backwards. Every time doctor tell her to do something, she was do it backwards. One time the doctor told her, listen nurse, go prick this guy's boil. Got heavy news flash today in newspaper. Attention, attention. Poland attacks itself. Another one of my friend, he's coming to drugstore. He say, listen, mister, I like to get some deodorant. I say, what do you mean, deodorant? He say, you know what I mean, the deodorant, you know. You got that Crown Royal. He say, you got the band. Oh, he says, you mean deodorant. He say, that's what I told you. Three times now, deodorant. He says, what kind do you want? The ball type? He say, no, I need something for underneath my arms. Talk about smell. A couple of my friends was walk down the street. They walked for a little bit. My friend said, Peter, you shut your pants today? Say, don't be crazy. What you talk about to shit my pants today? He said, you smell like svinya. So walk a little bit further. He said, Peter, I think you will shit your pants today. He said, now number two time I tell you, I don't be shit at my pants today. They walk a little bit further. He said, Peter, I don't believe you. Come around the corner. They go around the corner. He's got a pair of loose blue jeans. This son of a gun. He's go behind him. He's open up that blue jean. He look. He's put his hand to his kapusta. He say, you son of a gun. There was big clock right there. I thought you told me you don't shake your pants. He said, not today. Two of my friends, they was drink huriku like you never seen before, this guy, and was got a drunk, you know, got pretty hungry. So one guy say, listen, Mike, let's go hunt for some mushroom. He said, what the hell's matter with you? It's 3 o'clock to the morning. We can't hunt a mushroom. He said, I got a 3-cell flashlight. What we going to do? We're going to go to the grass like that, and we're going to look little bits around. Then we're going to find one there, and one there, and one there, and we're going to take it home. He said, you crazy. He said, how you know they're going to be good? He said, lots of those poisonous. We could die. Don't be worried, he told them. I got super actuary teri task bar to my tongue. I know what's good and what's bad. He said, good one, going to put to my pockets. Bad one, going to throw away. So they got out there and they start to hunt mushroom, you know, like big game hunter. He's flesh. Say, there one, son of a gun. Pick it up. Say, that's a good one. Shine around there this morning. That one, son of a gun. That's not a good one. So go there. Hot, there's one. He said, you know, that just tastes like dog shit. His friends say, oh boy, are we ever lucky we didn't step in it. One of my friends, he's gone to dealership, auto dealership. He said, hey, mister, you take a trade-in? I say, sure, I take a trade-in. Say, I want to trade my wife in on half-ton truck. This guy, something crazy to him for sure. So what do you mean you want to trade my wife? He said, I'm going to give it to sales manager. He go to sales manager, listen, Peter, he said, I got a kukuriku guy over here. He want to trade his wife in for half-ton truck. He had no humor. He say, hello, mister. Could I do something for you? He say, sure. You take trade in? Say, sure, I take trade in. Say, I want to trade my wife in for half-ton truck. He said, you serious? He said, of course I'm serious. He said, what do you want to trade your wife in for half-ton truck for? He said, well, to tell you the truth, he said, I need something with smaller bucks. And this beautiful hotel they put me in. Usually I live in shit houses, you know. But this hotel is just lovely. Got its steam beds, weights to lift up and down, and swimming pool, everything is just a hunky-dory. Manager come to me, he says, Nestor, you got to leave hotel. I says, what for? I just got here, for God's sakes. I'm having nice swim. He says, yeah, but you're peeing in the swimming pool. I says, so what? Everybody pees in the swimming pool. He says, from the high diving board. I got two friends, they was go ice fishing, they bring home 60 pounds ice. Think that's funny? Their wives drowned it in the kitchen trying to cook the goddamn stuff. Two Ukrainians standing by checkout counter. One says, my goodness, look at who's there. Nelly Golinchuk. Say, for Christ's sakes, Nelly, I don't be see at you for 10 years. How you are it? She said, well, Sarah, she says, to tell you the truth, she says, I don't feel it to myself lately. Sarah says, that's good. That was filthy goddamn habit you had anyway. Time to play a quiz. First number you, sir. You look intelligent guy. You know how you tell it, Ukrainian girl to nudist camp? No? By the slap pill ring on her ass. Number two quiz. Mrs.,
Mrs. Hello, cutie. Some bitch couldn't see you in the dark over there. You know how they play strip poker in nudist colony?
No.
With tweezer. Son of a gun. What it is? Oh, another one. Who knows over here how you tell it Ukrainian airplane? Very easy, simple. You look to the runway and the one with the hair underneath the wings, that's Ukrainian. Speak about airplanes, what about this one pilot, Jesus Christ, he's fly over the mountain, he's got into heavy difficulty trouble. Heavy snowstorm, wind is blowing, some beach plane go upside down, turn it around. He's got so excited, he started to cry. What, mommy, please help me. Make cock on his pants, everything's... Jesus, he never see something like that. He speak up to the microphone, he holler, Mayday, Mayday, John Kulmenko, number CFQ2C, Mayday, Mayday, Mayday. Very soon he's get answer from tourist over there with this go around in the sky, he say, please give us your height and position. He said, 5'6½" and I'm in the cockpit. Anyway, this guy, he start to pound nails. He's pound about 3 or 4, throw 6, 7 away, pound 7, 8 more, throw another 3, 4 away. His friend says, Peter, what the hell's matter with you? Why you throw all those nails away for? He say, no good to me. He said, why not? He says, they're pointing the wrong way. Says, you crazy bastard. He says, those for the other side of the house. Another, you know, talk about horses. This one guy, he was driving with his half-ton truck and he's go 100, you know, around the country to see what's happening. Pretty soon, he's look out his half-ton window. He see about 15 horses. But in front of these 15 horses, one black son of a bitch, he's run like wind. So he said to his friend, Peter, he said, who belong to that black devil horse over there, run like son of a bitch? He says, oh, that's John Skroikook's horse. He live half a mile. He said, let's go to see John. They go to see John. He says, John, Skroiko, he say, you got that the black horse, he run it like devil. He say, I want to buy that son of a bitch for you. He said, oh, gee whiz, Peter. He say, I like to sell you that damn horse, but he don't look too good. He said, he's look pretty goddamn good to me. He said, run fast like wind. He said, tell you what, I'm going to give you $300 for him. He said, no, I don't take no $300 because that horse don't look too good. He said, I give it you $4. He said, I don't take $4 because I told you that damn horse don't look too good. He said, third and final number I give it you, $600 last offer. Please don't refuse. I needed that horse. He said, for $600 you got him. So he's back his half-ton truck and he's pulled that damn horse on half-ton truck, take him home, open barn door, give horse crack on the ass and that horse run to the barn and he's run to the other side and he's banged his goddamn horse head over there on the door and he's fall down with leg up in there. His eye just rolled to his head like that, like slot machine. The guy figured, what son of a bitch is wrong with this bastard horse here? He's go to that horse and he's pass his hand like that to that horse's eye. That son of a bitch don't even blink it. He says, that son of a bitch, crinkle, he says, he sold it me blind horse, that dirty bastard. He's load that horse back to his half-ton, he take him to Skrinkle, he says, Skrinkle, you son of a bitch, I should shoot you. Why you sell me that blind horse for, you son of a bitch? Skrinkle looked at him and said, don't tell me why I sold him to you. I told you 3 times that horse don't look too good. Well, listen. One of my friends, he's phoned the police station to Edmonton. He says, come it quick. Come, please, quick. He says, because one girl here, she's died from bleeding to death. The policeman says, what do you mean she's bleeding to death? How she's bleeding? She cut herself bad? See, no, she don't cut herself. She She says she's fall downstairs, broke some bone. Says, no, she don't fall downstairs, broke no bone. He says, then what she bleeding to death from? He says, she's bleeding to death from the clap. He says, just goddamn minute. Nobody bleeds to death from the clap. Says, they do when they give it to me, son of a bitch. Anyway, this one guy has got charged to be head number one valedictorian to his class to the high school for a year. Now, he don't know nothing when he's got to this high school, but he has learned nearly perfect English. Speak better like me.
Attaboy, Nestor!
Thank you, buddy. Anyway, he's get up on stage, he's got whole damn family. Mother, father, 13 sister, 9 brother, 56 aunt and uncle. I'll stand over there, take 3/4 the goddamn auditorium. Now he's get up to the stage, he say, Mr. Principal, honored guest, mother, father, ladies, gentlemen. He say, you know, when I first come to this school, I could hardly speak the English good. And he say, you would never believe it, he says, but I am becoming one of those guys that you call a physical instructor in education and higher mathematics.
Whatever the hell that means.
He says, and do you realize it? When I first come at this damn place, excuse me, I didn't even know what pi r squared meant. Now his father jumped up from front row and he has jumped to stage and he has give these kids one shot to the face. And he says, you crazy son of a bitch. That's what I sent you to school for? He said, how many times I got to be told you? Pi are round, cake are square, you son of a gun. Three guys was go hunting. One Englishman, one Irishman, one Ukrainian. This Ukrainian guy weighed 462 pounds each leg. Fat son of a, and sloppy, this bugger could hardly tie his shoelace. Now they get caught in snowstorm, they knock on farmer door wife, you know, like you hear it. And they knock, and this farmer say, what's wrong? He say, we're lost, we don't know what we got to do it, we're cold, we're starving. He say, how can you do it? He say, come in, I'm gonna feed you supper, nice, you're gonna sleep to my place. He said, but I got good looking daughter. 43, 26, 49. One new son's bitch is put so much your finger to her, with the shotgun. So this girl, she serve him, cook him nice, but she keep look to these guys and give him wink from the eye like that. When her father don't look to them, just give like that. Move her shraka like that, then, you know, walk by. Put her bubaruni to the face, one sort of soap like that. So these three guys got to sleep in kitchen. Father, he sleep on second floor, daughter on third floor. Pretty soon Englishman said, he said, you know what, that girl winked at me all the time, winked at you, put the bubaruni in the ear, one in the eye, wiggle her shraka when she's, I can't give at a word. So he said, I'm going to creep up the stairs. So he's go very softly, start to creep up the stairs. He's get on second landing, make one move with his foot and floorboard go, farmer said, who there? This guy, he think, extra sanctuary fastness. He says, meow. He's don't hear no more. He step over that loose board, up the stairs, make a jig-a-jig, push, push, down the stairs. Says, your turn, but please remember, goddammit, to the Irishman that there is one loose board on that second landing. The Irishman says, don't worry, you're going to take it care. He's go up the stairs, but he's so excited, got like this. So excited. And he stepped to that damn creak. Farmer said, who's there?
Goes, meow.
He goes up, make a jiggy jiggy, push a push, come a down. Say to big fat slob Ukrainian, please, Kolomenko, believe it me, that's one loose board. Don't you step that son of a bitch, cause gonna make loudest noise like firecracker. He said, don't worry to me, goddammit, I'm going to take extra heavy care. He's go up that stairs like pregnant elephants. Step on that goddamn board, just go creak. Farmer says, "Who's there?" He says, "Creak, it's the cat." Thank you. Only guy has got to his anniversary. 50-year anniversary, go to same hotel, same room, do the same thing. He stand and dress. He's 76 years old, he stand and dress in front of the mirror like that, and he's move around like that. His wife looked to him, she says, "You know what, Johnny? 50 years ago, you was stand in front of that mirror and you was looking just like Greek god." She says, "Now you look like a goddamn Greek." Three guys smartest in the world arguing which is meanest animal they have it in the world. One guy says, "The meanest animal in the world is one those Bengal tiger, because they chew those people up 163 miles an hour." I said, "What do you mean Bengal tiger? They're not mean it." He said, "The most meanest animal in the world is one those water buffalo. You got it in the jungle from Africa." He said, "What the hell, those water buffalo not mean it?" He said, "The meanest goddamn animal the whole world ever seen is crocagator." Say, "What the hell you mean crocagator? You mean it crocodile?" He says, "No, crocagator." He said, "Oh, you mean it alligator." He said, "God damn it, number two time, crocagator." He said, "What kind goddamn animal crocagator?" He said, "That's animal that look like alligator and he's look like crocodile, but he's got head to each side of his body." Said, "Jesus Christ, you crazy? Animal that got it head on each side of his body couldn't even have himself a good shit." Says, "That's what make him so mean." Thank you, lovely people. We're going to see you again sometime. I love you. Bye-bye for now. Thank you.
This country needs is me. A vote for this old wine-stoned plowboy will bring us back to sanity. You ask me, Nestor, what can you do? I tell you this and it is true. I won't be giving you the finger. Like Trudeau saying, things ain't bad, fuddle doddle you. Just got a letter from Vancouver. Was coming to me postage too. Charge me $100 for storage. But that ain't bad. Postmark said 1892. Nestor, Mister, for Prime Minister. What this country needs is me. A vote for this old wine-stoned plowboy. Will bring us back to sanity. Now you take it, unemployment. You got no job and money's tight. You cannot live on what they give you. You use two names, get two checks, and live in constant fright. Now don't you never, never, never do this. When I'm Prime Minister, 'cause you see, I'm not so dumb like you think it. I'll catch you quick with that trick and throw away the key. Master, sister, for Prime Minister, what this country needs is me. A vote for this old wine-stone plowboy will bring us back to sanity. The van, don't split it up the nation. It just don't seem right to me. We need the Montreal Canadiens. beat the Russians at our game is top priority. Now those that were just two things that really bugged me. And I promise all you people,
bottle wine,
you will get if you will vote for me. Nestor, sister, for Prime Minister, what this country needs is me. Oh, vote for this old limestone flowerboy, will bring us back to sanity. Oh, vote for this old limestone flowerboy, will bring us back to sanity. Vote for me!
You know, I have trouble getting here today, son of a gun. We got terrible accident in Wagerville. They drop atomic bomb on us today. Did $1.33 worth damage, son of a bitch, you know. And my family, they're crazy like you never seen before. I got one brother, he got killed in pie eating contest. Cow was stepped to the back of his head, son of a gun. Oh, another one, my brother, he's got so drunk from that snow golf today, he's got hanging over like you've never seen before. He was taking a drink of milk and the cow fell on top of him and killed the son of a bitch. Everywhere in trash machine, make everything hunky-dory. That's a small Ukrainian boat, hunky-dory. I don't know what the hell you're doing over there, but did you wipe yourself?
Let me check.
You know, his mother sent him telegram. He say, you're in big city, Prince George. Remember, Peter, when you're in big town, remember what to do. Your high-class hotel. When you put your shorts on in the morning, remember, the brown spot goes to the back, you son of a gun. I will tell you about my wife. She's got to me all the time, son of a gun, every morning. She say, Nestor, I got such bad heartburn. Nestor, my heart's burning like you never seen before. So I put down a newspaper and I look over and her left cheek guy in the coffee cup. She say, Nestor, I got terrible news for you. I'm pregnant again. I say, son of a gun, we already got 14 kids. Why you don't take birth control pill? She says, they no good to me. I say, why not? She says, because every time I stand up, they fall out. I got another crazy brother. He's got to get job in big city. He's got job to be a photographer. But he got fired, son of a gun. Instead of using Polaroid, he used hemorrhoid and he got fired for taking shitty picture. I come, you know, I go to the Ukraine, I sent Airmail Express to get new sex pill, you know, make you potency. But they don't got complete yet. Only trouble with those damn things, you got to swallow them real fast or you get a stiff neck. One of my friends, he has got so much trouble with his shraka, don't know what to do. You know what shraka means? That means, you know, here, you know? He's got pile hang, but like my brother over there, like Danny Purcell. He could hardly walk, just go like this, little bits all the time, you know? He's go to doctor put him over table, look good. He say, well, Peter, you got a hell of a case hemorrhoid. What I gonna do, give you this suppository, you go home, use one every 6 hours. But he's a little bit cuckoo to the head. He don't know what minute suppository. He don't want to say nothing because he think doctor think he's foolish. So he's go home, he say to his wife, honey, what's minute this suppository? She says, no, what doctor told you? He say, use one every 6 hours. So for whole week, every 6 hours, he swallow one of these goddamn things with glass water. Come Monday, he could hardly move it, just like that. He's get to half ton truck, he's got put inner tube, you know? Just drive to doctor office first gear. He's get to doctor office, doctor says, well, Peter, how's your hemorrhoids? He says, geez, they killed me. Here, come to my eye. He said, don't you use the suppository I give you? He said, those goddamn things, for all the good they did me, I could have shoved them up my ass. You know? I know a couple Ukrainian guys that was go to hunt in jungle. One guy he's got at last, never had any water, nothing to eat for 3 days. He's come to this village. He see this meat market. They got Scotchman, $1.33 pound. Irishman, $2.49 pound. Englishman, $5.63 pound. Jews, $1.98. Ukrainian, $44.97 pound. He said to butcher, how come such heavy extra expense for Ukrainian? Butcher looked to him and said, huh, you ever tried to clean one of them bastards? Another guy, he was going to go bear hunting. Yorkton, Saskatchewan. You know where Yorkton is? It? That's good national Udi town, son of a gun. He's got Indian guide and the guy puts no shoes on, got some kubasa, some tobacco, some home brew it. Go have a hell of a good time. Indian, he say, listen, I'm going to show you how to hunt bear. They walk to a cave, this Indian, he's put his head in cave, he go, ooh. Don't got no answer. Walk a little bit more, put head in cave again, go, ooh, boom, 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 boom. Don't got no answer. Walk another one, give it a, ooh, 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 ooh. Pretty soon come answer, ooh, ooh, ooh. He say, you wait here, I'm going to be back a couple minutes. Now, my friend, he's waited out there for 6.5 hours. He's run out of kubasa, don't got no more haruko, no more tobacco, his pile start to hurt him pretty good. He said, what this son of a gun's doing there? He's walked to cage, and in back of cage, this Indian guy, he's got some good-looking chicken blankets, make a jiggy-jiggy, push-a-push, you know? Says, aha, that's what this voo-voo's all about. So he goes out, he put his snow shoes on again, he's run to cave, he go, woo. Don't got no answer. Run to another cave, woo. Don't got no answer. Run to another cave, woo. Pretty soon come reply, woo woo, woo woo. Jeez, he get all excited. He's take off all his clothes, hat, shoes, running shoes, socks, shorts. He's running to cave. He's don't got stitch of clothes on, nothing. Next Monday morning, Yorkton Enterprise got a big headline. Bare naked Ukrainian killed by freight train. Another couple of guys, they was go hunting, and this one guy, he's pretty fidgety, you know. He don't know what to do it. So my friend said, what's the matter with you? He said, well, he said, I got to go to bathroom. Got to do number two it. He said, we'll go to bush. He said, I don't got no paper. He says, use dollar bill. What the hell's matter with you? So he says, good idea. He's come back about 10 minutes later. Let me tell you people, this guy, he is just one big mess. He's covered with caca between his finger, got on his shoulder and on his elbow, underneath his fingernail. Friend says, what the hell happened to you? Says, you son of a gun. He say, you ever tried to wipe your ass with 3/4, 2 dimes and a nickel? We got one guy from Vegreville. He's coming home from Korean War. He's got a bunch of souvenir to his knapsack, you know? And he's got a bunch of souvenir, and he's got some make big party, homecoming party. Everybody's there, aunties, uncle, cousin, every neighbor, everybody. Got a hell of a home brew, pierogi, kubasa, everything. Nice, good. Pretty soon, grandpa, he's got to go to toilet, you know, but he doesn't want to make no never mind, so he's go to one in bush way out in there, you know. He sit down doing his business. Somebody said, Peter, what's that damn thing? It look like small pineapple. He said, that's heavy danger, heavy danger. He said, you put that to your teeth, pull that pin and throw it, make a big explosion, kill 20, 30 people. He said, I don't believe it. He said, show me. He said, all right, I'm going to show you. By this time, he's had too much horukyu. He's pretty drunk it. He's take that thing and he's put to his teeth and he throw this damn thing and he's miss his aim and it land right beside outhouse. Jesus, it's make a big explosion and the leaves and branch fall from tree, the shit house in smithereen. Grandpa, he come out with his pant around the ankle and he said, Jesus Christ, it's a good thing I didn't let that one go in the kitchen, huh? There's one guy, his own apartment house. His vacuum, you know, with Bissell broom cleaner. All of a sudden he hear, help, 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 help. He's run to check every door, son of a gun, nothing's happening. Finally, one door open, he's run, nobody in living room. Help, help. He figures, somebody's got killed in bedroom. He run to kitchen, grab a butcher knife, run to bedroom. Here is chick lying on bed, she's having baby. He said, mister, help me, I don't know what to do. You grab the head, I'm going to push you, pull, let's see what's going to happen. He's get down there and he's pulling, she pushing, he's pulling, she push. Pretty soon, baby fall right in hand. But it's don't say one damn thing. She's got heavy extra excited. She say, mister, mister, spank it, spank it. He grabbed the baby by the feet and he's give it. You son of a gun, don't you ever go in there again. You beautiful people, I like to tell you about Mrs. Jobchishin. She's in hospital, so she's got a beautiful baby. It's come time to feed the baby. Nurse bring baby, she take one chichka out, put in baby's mouth, start to sing nice lullaby. She's looked to this baby, something peculiar to him. Couldn't figure to her kapusta, what the hell. Finally she realized, look at my babies, don't got no eyelids. She get heavy, extra excited. She called to nurse, nurse called to doctor. Doctor come over and say, what's wrong, Mrs. Jobchishin? She said, look to my baby, what are we going to do with? He's don't got it some eyelids. How are we going to drive combine? Dust going to got to his eye. Can't look to sun, what are we going to do with? Say, don't worry, Mrs. Jobchishin, you lucky woman, you happen to be got it, boy baby, what are we going to do? Circumcise him little bits. We're going to take that skin and we're going to put one eyelid over here and another eyelid over there. Now she scratched her kapusta and she say, you know, doctor, that's not a bad idea. But it's not going to make him look a little bit cockeyed. Hey, say, Mrs. Jobchishin, don't you worry, it's going to make him look cockeyed. Look how the foresight he's going to have it.
Listen, we got a new gasoline. Heavy-duty petroleum industry, everybody going kukuriku to the kapusta. We could make it fuel from pig shit. That's right. Fuel from pig shit. Don't give you more miles per gallon, but it sure stops the siphoning from the tank. I was come here with my manager, take us 3.5 hours to get to this place. He says, how come you drive so slow? He said, I don't know, there's black ice on the road. I said, I never heard of black ice, but I heard of yellow snow. One of my friends, wife phoned other friend's wife. He said, hello, Nelly, how you was? She said, not bad, not bad, thank you. She, how's things?
Oh, not bad.
How's sex life? Very good, thank you. She said, you still using that diaphragm? She said, I threw away this afternoon. So you threw away this afternoon? You want to get pregnant? She said, no, I don't want to get pregnant, but Peter phoned me this afternoon, he said, I just bought condominium. One guy has come up to chicken hatchery. He said, give me 500 chicks. Another 3 days, he's come back to chicken factory, he said, give me another 500 chicks. But another 4 days, he come back, says, give me another 500 chicks. He says, son of a bitch, what are you doing with all these chicks? Say, I don't know what's happening. Either I'm planting them too close together or too deep. One of my friends come to Dr. Akus, you never believe that. He say, doctor, I want to be got castrated. Doctor say, you must be crazy. Who wants to be castrated? He say, I got work for 15 years. Never got a holiday. I take 3 months leave of absence. I got to be castrated. So I say, son of a gun, you want to be castrated? I'm going to castrate you. book him into hospital, give him... Now he's in recovery room. Son of a gun, he's deep power heavy duty expense pain actuates, you know. He's moaning, he's groaning, he's moaning, he's groaning. He don't know what to put his hands. Like, kick like that, you know. And he's look over to the other bed, and here's one guy, he's looked for the cheaper. He said, oh, oh, son of a gun. He said, you look pretty cheap and whipper. He said, what's happened to you? He said, oh, nothing much. I just come here to get circumcised. 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 Circumcised! God damn it! That was the word! I got one woman, she's going to work for a rich lady. Every time rich lady come down, she's wore a chinchilla fur coat. And the maid looked to her, she said, oh my goodness to you, how could you afford that fur coat like that? She said, all you needed to do is find that one guy with $20,000. So another 6 months passed by. Now it's maid's night on. Who's coming down the staircase but Sira Gulinchu? And she's got it to her back for coat. And the woman of the house looked to her and she said, my goodness, Sarah, you finally found it to a guy with $20,000. She says, no, but I found 2,000 guys with $10 each. One guy, he's got a wife. She's worked hard all her life. She's never had a fur coat in all her life. You understand this, mister? Honest to God. Is that fur coat? Anyway, he said to his wife, sweetheart, you go to the fur store, you buy it, any kind of coat you want. So she's go to the fur store. How many ladies ever go to fur store to buy fur coat? Put up your hand, please. I'm not going to make fun of you. Put up your hand. Look, 1, 2, 3, 4, like, yeah. Affluent society over here, son of a gun. But then she was go. Now, when you go to a fur store, how many times you ever see it, the salesman to the fur store? You ever see a salesman? No, sorry. They're all in the back cutting up jackpots. How to screw everybody from their money, right? That's true. So she walk up to fur rack, she take this coat, she put to her back, and she don't even realize what kind of coat is. It's chinchilla. And she start to pirouette around that mirror like that. She's looked to herself. Oh my goodness, look how beautiful that son of a gun. She's got so excited. She's break little bit's wind. Son of Magan, just when she's breaking wind, who walk in? Salesman, huh? Now she's got heavy duty excited. She said, oh, mister, please forgive me, she said. I don't know what I do. This coat looks so beautiful. I was put on my back. I turned around. I got so excited. I left a little bit spark go. He said, lady, think nothing of it. Wait till you hear the price, you shit! Couple of my friends from Wagerville, they was going to go to Las Vegas. Now they get to half-ton truck, and they start to drive it. They got to Nevada jackpot over there. Stop, play slot machine for a little bit's time. Lose couple, three quarter. Say, son, we're going to buy 12, 14 beer, and we're going to start driving. Now they buy 12, 14 beer, suck like they're thirsty, like... Pretty soon it's come at dusk time. Night start to fall very quick on desert. They see about 3/4 mile away lights to the distance. Say, son of a gun, we're going to get to this town. What we going to do it? We're going to stop to the station. We're going to wash our hands. Got a nice hamburger. Have something to eat. Nice. But John, he start to drink too much beer. He say, Peter, you got to stop the truck because I got to go make pee-pee. say, wait, you son of a gun, we're going to be to gas station pretty soon. He say, you stop this crutch right now, we're going to make pee-pee to my new blue jeans. He say, come on, stop for a little while, don't be crazy. He say, stop the crutch right now, honest to God, I'm going to make flood over here. He say, okay, you got to go, I'm going to stop the truck, and stop the truck. Park to the side of the road, he say, son of a gun, if he going to go, I'm going to go too. Said they go beside one of these cactus plants, you know? They go there behind, pull down zipper, start to do their business. All of a sudden, one rattlesnake jump up and his bite. Hold it. His bite peter right to the tip of his jadru. Fall down to the sand and he's wriggling and waving like that. Say, help me, John, help me, please, John. I don't know what I'm going to do. John, help me, help me. Say, run to get doctor. John, he forget all about truck to side the road. He start to run to son of a gun. He's run through the bush and he's run through the cactus, over the field and over the sand and through the stream. And he's running to town. He said, where's doctor? Where's doctor? Somebody say, doctor office over there. He's run to doctor and he says, doctor, doctor, come with quick. My friends got bit by rattlesnake. Doctor said, listen, buddy, like to be helping you, but I have to do cesarean section right now. He said, I don't care cesarean section. He says, I got 14 sections of aggravation. He said, come quick. Doctor said, I can't come, but tell me what I'm going to do. Here's what you call it, sharp knife, call it scalp. Understand it? You go to your body, and you take this knife, and you make one cut that way, another cut this way. And he say, you put your mouth. To where he was got it deep, and you suck out all the poison. And he gonna be okay. So he take this damn thing and he start to run. Through the sand, through the cactus, through the stream, through the sand. And he's run over and Peter his life to the sand. He say, John, where's the doctor? Where's the doctor? He says, he couldn't come. He's got to operate on section. He says, operate on section. He says, what he told you? He says, he told me, you're going to die.
On the first day after Christmas, my true love give it me. One huge Christmas tree. On the second day after Christmas, my true love gave it me two purple necktie and one huge Christmas tree. On the third day after Christmas, my true love gave it me 3 pounds of tobacco, two purple necktie and one huge Christmas tree. On the fourth day after Christmas, my true love gave it me 4 packets cigarette paper, 3 pounds of tobacco, two purple necktie and one huge Christmas tree. On the fifth day after Christmas, my true love gave it me 5 golden shirts with ring around the collar, 4 cigarette paper, 3 chew tobacco, 2 purple necktie. Single girl, oh boy, that's a heavy duty book, you know. 5 golden shirts with ring around the collar, 4 cigarette paper, 3 chew tobacco, 2 purple necktie, and 1 used Christmas tree. On the 7th day from Christmas, my true love gave it me 7 buttons.
burnt out light bulbs. That's for my dark room, you know. Sex and a single girl. Hoo-hoo-hoo. 5 golden shirts with ring around the collar. 4 cigarette paper, 3 blue tobacco, 2 purple necktie, and 1 used Christmas tree. On the 8th day after Christmas, my true love gave it me. 8 cans deodorant, that's for underneath the arms, you know, make you smell nice and sexy. 7 burnt out light bulbs, sex and a single girl. 5 golden shirts with ring around the collar. 4 cigarette paper, 3 two tobacco, 2 purple necktie, and 1 used Christmas tree. On the night after Christmas, my true love gave to me 9 speed bicycle, 8 cans deodorant, 7 burnt out light. Hold it. 9 speed bicycle? I don't know. 6 and a single girl. 5 golden shirts with ring around the collar. 4 cigarette paper, 3 two tobacco, 2 purple necktie, and 1 used Christmas tree. On the 10th day after Christmas, my true love gave it me 10 headache tablets. I don't know, this song making me cuckoo to the kapust. I can't take no more. 9 speed bicycle, 8 cans deodorant, 7 burnt out light bulb, 6 and a single girl, 5 golden shirts with ring around the collar, 4 cigarette paper, 3 blue tobacco.